Sources of finance. This was the last topic which we had seen yesterday. As we had seen, finance is considered as the lifeblood of business, and we can categorize the finance requirements of a business unit into these four: promotional capital, long-term capital, short-term capital, and development capital. And you have to remember, promotional capital is for the initial activities, like in order to promote the new business, project planning activities, feasibility studies, SWOT analysis. Those activities, the capital which we are requiring for the initial stages. Then there is long-term capital, short-term capital. We have to go into detail regarding long-term capital and short-term capital. Then development capital is required for what? Expansion, diversification, modernization of business, those activities. Like now the business is set up. Now whatever they are spending for, we can say expanding their business. Like we can say purchasing new machinery, purchasing a new factory, or even setting up a new factory for expansion, introducing a new product in the company. For all those activities, we need development capital. So this is the capital required for expansion, diversification, and modernization of business activities. Then we have to know, as I told you, long-term capital, that is fixed capital and working capital, that is short-term capital, we have to learn in detail. What is fixed capital? It is a relevant topic. At the same time, topic which you all have heard since so many, like till now, whatever you have studied already, you might have learned about what is fixed capital, what is working capital. Still, in a very brief way, we have to see what is this. Fixed capital is that amount of capital required for purchasing fixed assets like land, building, plant, machinery, etc. It is long-term capital. Like whatever we are investing in such assets, that amount is coming under fixed capital. So it is basically which we are investing for long-term assets, and this can be varying from company to company. It is easily defined as the amount invested to include or to buy land, building, and other assets which are having a relatively permanent usage in the business. So fixed capital is required for meeting long-term needs, because we will not buy assets and all for a short period. Such assets like plant, machinery, land and all, we will not buy these for a short period. We will be having a long-term plan. So for that investment, whatever investment we are putting into that, that is coming under fixed capital. Then it is needed at the beginning. Fixed capital is required at the beginning itself. Withdrawal not possible. Like normally when we are investing this amount in these capital, in these assets, it is not easily withdrawable, because this is something which we are doing for a long period. Then it is collected from various sources, that again, we will see which are those various sources. The requirement is variable. Not every company will be having the same type of requirement for fixed capital. Depending on the nature of the business, depending on the size of the business and all, it will vary. So it is, but it is much more, amount will be much more when you compare it that with the working capital. Then it needs long-term planning, because many units or many companies may face problems if they don't have sufficient amount to invest in the fixed capital. Then appreciation and depreciation. The value of the fixed assets can appreciate. Appreciate means can increase, or it can even depreciate. And depending on the economic conditions, like land and all, land and all, when we purchase and we use it as a fixed investment, and after some years, we can find out that the value has appreciated. Sometimes machines and all, even if you purchase it after some years, we can find out that the value has decreased because the machines are no longer useful in the market now. So fixed capital resources, like all these equipments involve both appreciation and depreciation. It acts as a source of strength for the entrepreneur, because it helps in survival of the business and also stability in the business. And it is required, or it shows that the organization is earning profit, or to an extent we can say it shows the strength of the organization or backbone of a business enterprise. Now, depending on the nature of the business activity, size of the business unit, type of the product to be manufactured, and the technology used in that company, all these things, the fixed capital requirement will be varying from company to company. Now, these are various sources of fixed capital. By issuing shares, we can collect it, issuing of preference shares, issuing of debentures, plowing back of profit. This may be a new term. What is plowing back of profit? Plowing back of profit means with the accumulated profit in the company. Profit will be accumulated. We can accumulate it. We can keep it together. All the profits can be kept together. So with this, this amount can be invested for arranging fixed capital, arranging the assets. That is plowing back of profit. It is also known as retained earnings or reinvestment. So whatever profit we are getting, that is reinvested into getting of or purchasing of assets. That is plowing back of profit. Then bank loans, definitely the source of fixed capital. Lease financing. Lease financing means where there will be companies. Leasing, I think all of you might be knowing. Leasing means basically taking on rent. So there are so many lease financing companies. What they do is that they provide these machines and equipments and all on lease basis. And the company which is requiring these equipments, they can take the possession of the machinery or the equipment, whatever it is, and they can pay the lease amount for the same. So in this case, we don't require huge investment for fixed capital. So this is one source of easily getting the assets. Then loans from specialized financial institutions. That also we will see which are those financial institutions. Like it is apart from the regular banks, we can say there are institutions like IDBI, ICICI, then many other SIDBI, many other institutions which are providing financial support. Then venture capital. Venture capital also we will see in detail, but now I'll tell you what is venture capital. It is a form of financing by certain specialized institutions to high risk companies, especially in the initial stages of the companies or initial stages of introducing the company in the market. So these are the different sources of fixed capital. Then working capital is also known as circulating capital. It can come for objective question. Working capital is also called as circulating capital. It is that part of the capital required for meeting the day-to-day expenses of a business unit. Like, of course, fixed assets are there. That is also invested for long-term purpose. But working capital is required for taking care of the day-to-day activities of the business, like purchasing of raw materials, purchasing of other stores items, payment of wages to the employees, even other regular expenses like paying the electricity charges, water charges, fuel charges, paying the taxes, etc. So this is continuous in nature. It is recurring in nature, but fixed capital will not, we will not every time keep on investing in fixed capital because it's already done and it will be for a long term. But working capital is a recurring expenditure, recurring in nature. But this is also equally important for the adequate and smooth running of the business. Now, here again, working capital is also dependent on the nature of the business, then the technology used, manufacturing cycle, the length of the manufacturing cycle, because if the manufacturing cycle is too long, then continuously goods will be required, and continuously goods will be required means greater will be the amount to be invested in the materials. Then labor, depending on the type of employees we are having in the company, based on all these things, working capital is important. Now, another thing which you have to remember here is source of working capital. Sources of working capital, first is trade credit. Trade credit kya hota hai? Trade credit is very convenient, commonly found working capital source. Like we can say that it is extended for a period of 30 days, 60 days and all. When you are getting credit from the suppliers or from other dealers and all this will come under trade credit. Bank overdraft. Bank overdraft consists of an agreed term of credit between the entrepreneur and the bank, where they can withdraw the amount. Like it is for a period of 6 to 12 months. They can withdraw an amount in case of immediate cash requirement. Then cash credit. Cash credit is also similar to this trade credit only, but here we can say that it is based on the hypothecation. Hypothecation means when we have to keep our inventories and books and all for hypothecated, then we will be getting cash credit. bill discounting from the debtors that can be discounted with the banks, provided that the amount will be discounted. And this is one easiest method for getting the finance. Self-financing means where internal source, our accumulated fund itself, is used for day-to-day activities. Then there is dealer's advance. Dealer's advance means, again, getting amount from the dealers or the suppliers well in advance. And then the product will be delivered later. These are the different commonly available sources of working capital. Now we will be reading about different financial institutions which are providing financial support to the entrepreneurs. So government has set up so many such institutions, like national level financial institutions are there, state level financial institutions are also there. Some of the few names we will see over here. You will have to remember the full form over here, because in objective questions there are chances that it will be asked. So there is first one, Industrial Finance Corporation of India. They again help in financing the entrepreneurs. Then there is ICICI. We commonly call it as ICICI, but the full form is Industrial Credit and Investment Corporation of India. Then there is Industrial Development Bank of India, IDBI, Industrial Reconstruction Bank of India, IRBI, National Industrial Development Corporation, Maharashtra State Financial Corporation, State Bank of India. Then another important one is Small Industrial Development Bank of India, that is SIDBI, Small Industries Development Bank of India. Now, what are the operations undertaken by these institutions? Most of these operations are like by providing finance to the institutions. Which type of institution? Entrepreneurial institutions. Then they will help in setting up of new industrial projects, expanding the existing industrial projects, renovating the existing industrial projects. Then they also provide in help in promotional activities in various areas. Then they will be even providing what we can say, capital for provided, like not only for fixed assets, but also for the working capital also they will be providing the help. Then they will also help in developing the company, supporting services to be provided to the company, and even promotion of employment oriented industries, especially in rural areas or semi-urban areas and all, so that more employment opportunities can be created. And to an extent, it will also help to check the migration of the people, movement of people from the rural areas to the urban areas. So they also provide seed capital. Seed capital means the capital required for initial, like just like promotional capital, the seed capital is required for setting up of the business initially. Then, like that, so many schemes are there which are given by these organizations, these financial institutions. You have to remember the names and also try to remember the full form over here. Now, another important topic here is venture capitalist. What is a venture capitalist? Who is a venture capitalist? Let us see the meaning over here. This is also a new concept, but it can play a very major role in helping the entrepreneurs to arrange the funds or arrange the companies. So who is a venture capitalist? A venture capitalist means a person, or it can be group of people, that makes venture investments. They bring managerial technical expertise as well as capital for a company. It refers to pooled investment. Pooled investment means where they will be taking finance from various areas or various places or various individuals, and they will be accumulating it together and investing in a venture, investing in a business. They are managed by VC firm. VC means venture capitalist firm, which often employs individuals who are having very good technology backgrounds, business training, and deep experience in the industry. So they will not invest in each and every venture which they are seeing. Only after careful studying, they will be providing this venture capital. It is a form of private equity financing that is provided by venture capital firms or funds, or we can say startups. Startups are there. I think you all of you know what are startups. So they provide funds to startups in the early stage and even emerging companies that have been deemed to have high growth potential or which have demonstrated high growth. Some three names I have mentioned over here, which are in India, which are the we can say which are the active venture capitalists in India: Helion Venture Partners, Axel Partners, and Bloom Venture Capitals or Ventures. So, what is this venture capital? These are pooled investment. What they do? The venture capitalist, they have this ability to identify new technologies, new companies, and which all companies can succeed in the market. They play a role in managing these entrepreneurial setups in an earlier stage itself. That is why funding normally happens in the early stage. And they will also invest in such companies which they feel that will be having a high growth potential. So several investors, what they do, they are combining their investments in one large fund, which is invested in these type of entrepreneur ventures. So this can be like, normally it is structured as partnerships, and these partners are considered as the managers of this firm, and they will be helping these startups or these small entrepreneurs to start their business and take it ahead. But their approaches will be different. Like, there are several venture capitalists in the market. All of them will not be behaving or functioning in the same manner. They will be having different factors which they will consider for investing in the business. Like, some venture capitalists will only invest in companies which are having new ideas, or some will be investing in companies which are already established but need funds to grow. Some venture capitalists will invest only in particular type of industries where they would like to see that continuing. Some will be investing only in their particular local area. Some will be investing on a global level. So their expectations are also different. Some venture capitalists invest their fund and they want a quick growth over there. So all these things will vary, but ultimately their role is to provide funds. So they are commonly referred as VCs or venture capitalists. And they will be having managers, as I told you, who will be highly qualified individuals with good technology background or even a finance background. Then there will also be people involved over here, like they are known as venture partners, principals, associated people, like that. Now, what, as I told you, their role is something very important, which can take a business ahead, which can help a business in starting up, and which will help the business to be continuing ahead successfully. Now, what will be the compensation? What are they getting in return? Of course, they will be into this business because they also would be expecting something in return. So what do we know about their compensation? So venture capitalists, they are compensated through different combinations. Like, again, depending on company to company, like sometimes it is by giving them management fee. There will be an annual payment done to this venture capitalist by the firm, and that is known as management fees. Then, other than that, this is one option, providing management fees. Other than that, they will be given an interest, a share of the profit of the fund, normally 2%, that will be provided to the or returned to the venture capitalist. And remaining, whatever is remaining, will be taken by the company itself. So this is only the we can say benefit or compensation which they are getting. But what happens is that they do this type of activities in order to help the smaller firms to thrive in the market, and in order to like many cases we can say that they will be having the technology, they will be having the know-how and all, but they will not be able to arrange the funds. So in such cases, such venture capitalists can be contacted, and they will be helping them to, or they will be teaching them how to invest in which type of industry, or what amount to be invested, how to start the business, and they will be guiding them in almost all the areas. So this is a venture capitalist. This also can come from objective questions. Okay, so we will see from the beginning. Now, this is Helion Venture Partners, Axel Partners are just names of some venture capitalists in India. Okay, I have just taken some examples of the venture capitalists in India. They are not any different types and all. Okay, just three companies which are there in the market. I just took the names so that you, like, whenever you read somewhere, whenever you search and all, you will be able to understand. Okay, so this is about the finance part of or sources of working capital, like we can say how to start a new venture and the institutional support. We saw from beginning steps in starting a new venture. Some companies are exempted from compulsory licensing, but at the same time, some companies require licensing or clearance or permission. Then how to tackle the pollution control needs, institutional support to entrepreneurs. These are also institutions only, which we had seen just now. That is about financial support. This is also institutional support here also. Here, but what happens? Majorly training, consultancy services, how to make a project report, how to conduct a feasibility study, such type of guidance, and to whom to approach in case of starting an enterprise. Such kind of guidance are provided over here. Then the prospects and opportunities, the problems, remedial measures to solve the problems, extension services given by the government, sources of finance, fixed capital, working capital, and these financial institutions are majorly involved in helping in finance for the company. As I told you, it can be national level as well as state level, and their criteria will be different. Okay, then last one, venture capitalist.